Let's continue the speculations, drawing comparisons to the infamous exploits of Jordan Belfort. He's known, of course, as the Wolf, the original, the real Wolf of Wall Street.
Name of the company, Aerotyne International. It is a cutting-edge, high-tech firm out of the Midwest awaiting imminent patent approval on a next generation of radar detectors that have both huge military and civilian applications. Now, right now, John, the stock trades over the counter at 10 cents a share. And by the way, John, our analyst indicator could go a heck of a lot higher than that. Hey, John, thank you for your vote of confidence and welcome to the Investor Center.
Yeah, thanks a lot, man. Thanks.
Bye-bye.
How the didn't do that?
The actual Jordan Belfort is with me. In 1999, he pled guilty to money laundering and securities fraud. After release from prison, he became a motivational speaker and wrote the memoir inspiring the movie. Jordan, it is absolutely brilliant to have you all on the program on this particular story. Now, look, this... The Reddit investors, the retail investors, don't at first blush look like they're doing anything illegal, if not particularly good. But what do you make of it? What does it smell like to you?
Well, if you could prove that they were actually colluding together, then it would be illegal. The problem is that, you know, it's sort of this sort of weird, loose collusion where, you know, one person says, let's stick together and stay strong. Theoretically, that's not legal, but I would doubt that the SEC would try to make a case out of something like that. I think more importantly, you know, what you have to realize here is that if just for the average person, that there's money to be made in this and money to be lost massively on both sides. You need to be really, really careful. And I think you could actually make a lot of money. And I have friends that are making a ton of money playing these hot, you know, Reddit stocks that are just being pumped up. It's truly, it's like a modified pump and dump, because at the end of the day, it will most certainly go back down because it's not trading based on any rational fundamental value. But, you know, as you said, and your last guest pointed out, stocks can stay up for a long time until they come back down.
Right. Now, and on that point, I mean, there's a reason why the professionals, I'm using that with a small p and an inverted commas because others would challenge that, the hedge funds would short those stocks in a moment for the time being. And yet, at the same time, these Reddits are basically using nothing more than the force of persuasion to sure, get everybody else into the leaking boat.
So what happens is there's the short sellers need to just be a lot more careful in this market. What happens is, just remember, every time the market goes up, like GameStop goes up, it's going to get harder and harder to make that next move up because the market cap eventually gets to the point it's just not sustainable. So at a certain point, you know, someone's got to be, you know, crossing out the people who were selling and moving on to the next one. So the question really is what is the overall size? Like, it's almost like they're a basket of these Reddit stocks. And there's a certain amount of buying capital that's going to be spread over amongst these different five or six stocks. There's no difference between one to the other. They're just all one in the same. In the same way the cryptos, they trade as a basket in the beginning, the same thing. So what has to happen here is eventually you'll find some equilibrium where it's basically the max amount of this sort of short-term hot capital that's going to go into these five or eight or 10 Reddit stocks will sort of reach its peak, and it'll have to flow from one to the next to the next. And eventually, smart short sellers are going to be able to time this and say, you know what, it's just simply, it's reached the peak of what the allowable capital is for all of these stocks together. And you can start really making a lot of money. And on the upside, if you're smart, you just got to get into these things when they first start making their run. So I think there's a lot of money to be made. And I think you're right. There is certainly some loose sort of weird crime going on, but it's going to be a very tough one to prove, I think.
No, but the regulators may try to step in to stop it, because I'm not suggesting widows and orphans get hurt in this, because we are sort of at a slightly more day trader, professional sort of extreme of it. And but I do ask, so what can and what do you think that the regulators should do?
Well, let me say you're right, by the way, because here's what's going to happen is that right now it's not widows and orphans, but who do you think the last people to eventually jump on the bandwagon are going to be? it's going to be the widows and also the unprofessional that keep hearing about it and hearing about it. And they're going to be the ones that end up getting in at the end of the party, and the professional day traders will move on to the next one. So that's, there are going to be some massive victims in this whole thing, and most certainly. And I think that, frankly, it's already starting. I think some of the brokerage firms like Ameritrade and others have suspended their own internal trading in some of these, you know, ultra hot stocks. And ultimately, I would not be the least bit surprised if the SEC or the NASD passes some sort of rules about the ability of people to really manipulate these stocks. Because here's what happens, Richard.
Sorry, you tell me what happens. You go on, you tell me.
Well, what happened? The wheels of, the SEC, when I was doing what I was doing, I was always trying to stay one step ahead, figure the next way to get around the laws. How do you do what you're going to do? Well, that's what's happening right now. And the SEC and NEC are playing catch up ball. They're always trying to figure out how to stop it. So eventually they will do something here and they'll come up with some laws or circuit breakers that don't allow this to happen. But that could take 3 to 6 months. It will eventually, I believe, stop, and it should.
Jordan, finally, I know you're under various restrictions and you can't trade and you can't do various things like this, that, and the other. So I'm aware of all of that. But when you saw this, did it get the blood racing? You know, did you for one
second? I can trade as much as I want. I can trade all I want. I just can't own a brokerage firm. The truth is that I have not been I have friends trading it, and I was tempted. But here's the thing. I just know it's got to be more of a full-time job. And because if you're on, it's like catching a falling knife when things start to go the wrong way. So I believe that you can make money, but you better be watching this all day long and have the stomach to play both sides of the equation. And I'm just not at this point in my life. I don't want to or really care to do that, but I could. I choose not to.
Very wise. Very wise. The mere thought of it. I look at this and I think, Richard, just have a go. And then I thought, as you say, it's catching the knife. Jordan, thank you so much. I appreciate it.
My pleasure.
It's great to talk to you. Thank you.